Hi, my name is Amy Heise, and today I'm going to be walking you through how to draw St. Elizabeth Ann Seton. I'm going to walk you through how to draw her step by step with simple lines and simple shapes. Her feast day is on January 4th, and she's also the patron saint of my local parish. I'm going to try to make my example match this one as close as humanly possible, but you can make any changes or additions that you want to on yours. Anytime we draw, it's good practice. So let's go ahead and get started. For this project, you need a piece of paper, a pencil, and something to color with. So the first thing that I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be working on her head. So her head in the example is a nice oval shape, so kind of close to the top of my paper. I am going to draw out an oval. And I like to do everything in pencil first. That way, if I make a mistake, it's easy to erase. And everybody's drawing is going to look a little bit different. And that's a good thing, kind of like how our handwriting is all a little bit different from each other. So once I get her oval put in for her head, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put a line on each side for her neck. This is also creating the collar of her clothing. So I put one line on the left and one line on the right, kind of like this. And then I'm going to connect these marks together with a curved line that's kind of like a smile. Then what I'm going to do is I am going to draw out the top part of her book. So her book is open and it kind of has a V shape. So in the example, you can see that the edges of the book come past her shoulders. So I want to make sure that my V shape is coming past where her shoulders are going to be. So I'm going to do one diagonal line like this and one diagonal line going off to the right like that. Then what I'm going to do is in the middle where the two edges of the book meet, I'm going to draw a line that goes down a little ways, kind of like this. And this is going to make the spine of the book that she's holding. So I'm going to add another line right next to it, like so, and connect them at the bottom. So then what I'm going to do is I am going to draw one line coming down on the left side and one line coming down on the right side. And I'm going to connect these lines to this bottom part of the book. So because the top part of our book kind of had this V shape, we want to make sure that we're angling the bottom part of this book in a similar way, like that. The last thing that we're going to add to the book is we're going to add a little bit of the pages peeking out. So at the spine of your book, I want you to draw a diagonal line that matches the direction of the book, and then you're going to connect it to that cover. And I have a little bit of gap between the pages, and the cover goes past the pages just a little bit. And I'm going to do the same thing over on this left side. I want the cover to extend past the pages of the book a little bit, and I'm going to have it connect to the spine like so. So then what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw in the top part of her dress. So I'm going to start with her shoulders. So kind of where her neck is, I'm going to do a slight curved line down. And if you hit her book, just stop and you can continue that part of her dress on the opposite side, kind of like this. And I'm going to do the same thing on the right side. I'm going to start her shoulder, kind of curve until I hit her book. And you might not hit her book depending on how big your book is. But if you do, you just stop and you just continue that line on the other side like that. So then what I'm going to do is I am going to draw in her little hands that are holding the book. I'm going to create a curved line like this. And that's for the thumb. And for the main fingers, I'm going to do a curved line kind of like this. So at the beginning, the hands almost kind of have a mitten shape. So we have like a curve for the thumb and these big curves for where the main fingers are going to go. And I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. I'm going to do a curved for the thumb. So that curve, it stops where the book is. And then my other big curve is for the fingers that are holding the back of the book. So I kind of get a mitten shape like that. And that just helps give me a general idea of where those hands are going to be. And I can erase this part of the book cover that I no longer need. Inside of these mitten shapes I did for the hand, I can separate this big curve into the four fingers. So I can just add a couple of lines, one, two, three, kind of like that, to help separate those fingers. And do the same on the opposite side, one, two, three. So then what I'm going to do is I'm going to add in her little arms. So I'm going to put in a shape kind of like an oval. So I'll put one on the left side like this, and I'm going to put another on the right side kind of like this. Then what I can do is her sleeves have these like white cuffs at the edge. So kind of in between the wrist and the elbow, I'm just going to put a curved line, kind of like a smile, to create this cuffed sleeve of her dress. And any lines that I no longer need anymore, I can erase. So I have this little bit of book that's peeking through. I'm going to erase that. So then I want to finish the top part of her dress. So right here on these edges where I left off, I'm going to curve them down until I hit her hand or the book, and I'm going to stop. Kind of like that. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to be working on her skirt. So where her waist is kind of lines up with where her shoulders are. So I'm going to have one part of her skirt start about here, and I'm going to do a swooping line coming off towards the left like so. And I'm going to do a similar curve on the opposite side. So here's her shoulder, and that's about where I want her skirt to start at the waist. And it's going to flare out towards the right side. And you can make this skirt however full or narrow you wish. If you want it fuller, you can just kind of make your lines a little bit wider. And if you want it narrower, then you can make them a little thinner. And I want to connect these edges of the skirt with a curved line, like a smile, to create the bottom. I'm going to erase these lines that I don't need anymore. And maybe you want to add a little bit of her foot poking out from underneath her skirt. Or maybe you want to add something that she's standing on. You can make any changes that you want to your drawing. So I think the last thing I'm going to do before I show you the head is I want to add a little bit of her arm kind of peeking out from behind her book right about here. And maybe your arm looks great just the way it is, but I think I'm just going to add that little line right there just to make it look like her arm is kind of tucked behind that book. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to be working on her bonnet. So her bonnet has this in and out wavy edge, and it goes all the way around her face starting by her chin. So here is her chin, and I'm going to start to pull my pencil out and then go in for the first wave and go out and in. And you can have as many of these ruffles or ridges to her bonnet as you wish. Just do however many fit. And if you have more than me, that's okay. If you have less than me, that is okay. We just want a wavy line going all the way around her head. The other thing that we want to do is we want to add in the slight curve. I have mine on the right side of the hat, and it's just poking out in between some parts of the bonnet, kind of like this. And this is like the back side of her bonnet. So depending on how big your ruffles are, you might be able to see a lot, you might only see a little bit. Whatever amount you have, that is okay. I think I might add a little bit more bonnet peeking out here. So you can see that even mine's a little bit different from this example, and that is okay. Then what I'm gonna do is I'm going to create this curved line, kind of matches the shape of her head, and this is gonna be for the strap for her bonnet. So right about here on the oval, I'm going to draw another curved line that matches the shape of her head. It's just kind of parallel. So that creates this little strap that is wrapped underneath her chin. And her bonnet is tied with a bow. So the way that I'm gonna do the bow is I'm going to do two loops, kind of like this, kind of look like eggs or oval shapes. And then I'm just going to do a line on the left and a line on the right. I'm going to be working on her hair next. So I have her hair parted in the middle. So in the middle of my oval, I'm going to draw a little line, kind of like that, for her hair part. And her hair, it parts a little bit towards the left and a little bit towards the right in a nice little swoop. So wherever you have the bottom of her hair, you're going to draw one line going off towards the left, and it just kind of swoops off the edge of her oval face. And I'm going to do one that kind of swoops off towards the right. And you can change her hairstyle however you wish. And then I'm going to be doing her eyes. I'm going to be doing kind of like a circle shape for the main part of her eyes. You just want to make sure that you're leaving a space in between her eyes. And her eyes are about the middle of the oval. So I'm going to do one circle more towards the left and one circle more towards the right, kind of like that. And I want to have a circle kind of at the top of the eye shape for these white highlights. Underneath that white circle, I'm going to draw in a little bit of a pupil. And to create the top part of her eyelids and eyelashes, I'm going to draw a curve, kind of like a frown on one eye and a curve on top of the other eye. So it kind of just comes past the circle for my eye a little bit on each one. And if you want to, you can add a couple eyelashes. I'm just gonna do two or three on each one. And I'm going to give her some eyebrows as well. So leave a little space above each eye and do a curve, think like a frown or a rainbow. Kind of matches the eyelid shape like so. Then we're going to be working on her nose. So kind of in between where your eyes are and the bottom of her face, kind of in the middle, I want you to put a little curve, and this is going to be the bottom of her nose. And I have a little hint of the edge of her nostril over on this right side. So I'm just going to do a little curve, kind of like a parenthesis, over on the right. And then I have kind of a more straight up and down line, creating a hint of the bridge of her nose. And maybe you want to do your nose in a different way. You can customize your Elizabeth Ann Seton however you wish. And then last but not least, she has this little smile. So I'm just doing a very simple smile. I am doing a little curve in between the nose and the chin. And I'm just going to put a little line kind of like right on the edge. That way she has just the hint of a smile. Once I finish my Elizabeth Ann Seton, if there's any changes that I want to make, like maybe I want to adjust some things on her face, or I want to add something, maybe I want to add a title to her book, maybe I want to give her a rosary, or draw a background. You can make any additions or changes that you want to. You can start to color her. I'm going to be using markers. And one thing I like to do when I draw with markers is I like to outline my drawing with a black pen, kind of like this. But you can color your Elizabeth Ann Seton with any colors or art supplies that you have on hand. Thank you so much for following along with me. I would love to see how your St. Elizabeth Ann Seton drawings turned out. Feel free to tag me on social media. If you enjoyed following along with today's tutorial, you can give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Another way you can support the channel is you can buy me a coffee. I want to remind you that you are loved. God loves you very much, and He loves your artwork very much. Thank you so much, and I'll see you next time.